movie had no right.
Holy crap, it's actually really good.
Really smart, really dramatically sound, and clinically spot on. We need to feel grief because it's part of our emotional experience. It's part of being emotionally healthy. We care, we lose, we grieve.
Yeah.
And if we deny ourselves that, what's going to happen is we stop caring.
Mm-hmm.
And we stop connecting, and we stop living.
I'm so glad I finally found you.
Hello and welcome to Cinema Therapy. I'm Jonathan Deckard, licensed therapist who loves movies.
I'm Alan Seawright. I'm a professional filmmaker who needs therapy.
And we're going to be doing movie family therapy for Gemma and Katie from the movie M3GAN.
They need some therapy, and they're going to need a whole lot more after this.
Yes. Oh my gosh. Actually, I'm not going to say what theme we're exploring. I'm going to let the movie give its own mission statement.
Giddy right up.
Jellyberries makes me feel good.
Katie, look. We're almost at the top of the mountain. Can you see the hotel?
Oh, well, that's interesting. You know what else is interesting?
That is interesting.
I thought we were going to limit screen time to 30 minutes a day.
What are you telling me for? I didn't get a turn.
I'm just saying. I think, Katie, can you turn it down, please?
The bathroom. Are we there yet?
I think if we make rules, we need to stick to them.
Look, if she wasn't on there, she'd be climbing all over the seats.
Oh, so you would rather she sat there feeding a toy virtual food until it shits itself? Katie, turn it down.
I already did turn it down.
What was Gemma thinking?
I was thinking it's my niece's birthday. I'm gonna get her a present.
She works for the company that makes them. She probably didn't even have to pay for shipping. Honestly, what is the purpose of a toy if you have to play with it on an iPad?
This is what the future looks like, okay? Just have to get used to it.
Oh my god!
And away we go!
I love how much this movie knows what it is immediately.
Yeah, yeah.
It's so, this movie is super fun.
It is. Well, and that's the thing, like, it's scary, but you can't stay scared because you're laughing so much.
It's, yeah, it's scary asterisk.
And it's funny, and it's surprisingly deep.
Yeah, there's a lot to it.
Do you think what Aunt Gemma said is true? That he's in a better place now?
No.
I admire films that give you right up front, here's what the movie's going to be about.
Yep.
Because there is a mission statement at the very beginning. How much screen time is too much?
Mm-hmm.
Are we too dependent on technology? Are we not connected? Look, there's the mountain. There's the hotel we're going to.
Okay.
You know what else is interesting?
Yeah.
And so the entire film is saying, okay, at what point do our distractions harm us?
Okay.
Which I think is fascinating for us because here we are on YouTube, we're talking about movies, but we also talk about what's healthy mentally and in relationships, and there is such a thing as too much of a good thing.
Screen time is bad unless you're watching our show.
No, screen time is not bad. Video games are great, movies are great, television is great.
Oh, yeah.
But where's the life balance? Ready Player One explores similar territory.
True.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Jono. Hey, Jono.
Привет. Hola, amigo, ¿cómo estás?
Ты почему так говоришь?
И ты, ¿por qué hablas así?
Oh, ich verstehe. Was passiert?
You've been using Babel again.
Det har lustigt. Du har studiert språk med hjälp av Babel.
Did you know that you can use Babel to have practical, real-world conversations through short, 10-minute interactive lessons?
В идеальном отем.
The lessons are designed by real human language teachers, not artificial intelligence.
Да.
And they have lessons, podcasts, games, videos, y mucho más.
Vou forklara do miteta.
There are professional development lessons too to help you navigate the business world.
But can Babel help an aunt with a difficult relationship with her niece, defeat a rampant AI and prevent the robopocalypse?
Oh sure, you betcha. I'm sure they're working on it. But it can help me to communicate with people all over the world as I'm traveling with my family.
And help us communicate with you.
Well, we do have viewers all over the world and we want to be able to come visit you and talk with you. Maybe stay over, eat some of your cereal, borrow your toothbrush, recycle your toilet paper.
So click the link in the description below to get 60% off of your subscription.
There's also a 20-day money-back guarantee.
What a deal! You can start speaking in just 3 weeks.
¿Dónde está el baño?
Nice.
Oh no. Es demasiado tarde.
So obviously, big car accident. Katie's parents go bye-bye. And... I'm keeping up with the irreverent insensitivity of the film, all right?
Now imagine what a toy like Megan could do for hundreds of thousands of kids all across the world, even the ones who don't have dead parents.
Her Aunt Gemma doesn't know how to parent, but she basically takes Katie under her wing because her sister's dead, Katie's mom. Such a damning commentary. She's still got the wounds from the car accident and her aunt's just on her phone.
Listen, Katie, I have this project at work that's kind of overdue. And with all the time that I had to take off last week, I'm not really sure I'm gonna get it done. Anyway, it's not gonna take longer than a couple of hours, but if you could just hold down the fort by yourself for a little while, that would help me so much. You can use my iPad if you want. You can FaceTime a friend or play a game or something.
What about screen time? How long before I have to turn it off?
Oh, I don't care, as long as you want. I mean, I'm not gonna be gone that long. I'll just be down the hall. And when I'm done, we can go out somewhere. We can go to a playground or get something to eat. Okay?
Very subtle winner in that scene is the production design.
Mm.
Really, really strong color theory in there. The sort of warm browns all surrounding Allison Williams, Gemma. And then the green on the wall and on her shirt. It's all telling you like, hey, it's a warm and cozy space, except the green is saying, but not quite.
Yeah.
People don't think a lot about production design when you're watching a movie because you shouldn't. Like, you shouldn't be noticing the production design.
But you feel it.
Unless it's a Kenneth Branagh movie, then you should be noticing it.
Yeah.
Because it's in your face. But you should feel it.
Mm-hmm.
And you really do in this movie.
And Gemma's doing what so many of us do as parents, which is however much time you want, no limits.
I need to do something right now, so just...
Yeah, and I've definitely...
Yeah, I've done that plenty of times.
And I think within limits... That's not a bad thing.
Oh, look, occasionally you've got an hour and a half thing that you need to do. And it's like, okay, go watch a movie.
Yeah, just fine. Please. But Gemma is the very definition of a detached mother figure at this point. And her coworkers say, hey, yeah, we got a lot of pressure with our project, but your niece just lost her mom.
Yeah.
Like, go be with her. It's not even a critique on being career focused because that's who Gemma wants to be.
Sure. Nobody's saying she shouldn't be.
But this was foisted upon her, and in this case, she's saying, well, the technology raised Katie, which we're going to step into in a major way. And the thing about no limits is there are studies that show that if you have too much screen time, it actually messes with your nervous system.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Yeah, it like rewires your brain and does some interesting stuff.
Which is one of the reasons why they tell you not to be on your phone before you try and go to sleep. Mm-hmm. You ever been on your phone scrolling and then you can't go asleep and you feel kind of like
a little
edgy?
Jittery, yeah.
Yeah. I've even had the thing where I'm like scrolling through Instagram videos, like funny Instagram videos. And I'm like, it is now 3 a.m.
Why am I still doing this?
I've been doing this for 4 hours. And to actually turn it off and close it. Have you ever felt
like a huge amount of mental energy to be like, I'm no longer doing this. Yes.
Yeah. It's wild. And so we need to be careful because kids need connection and they need reality. Yeah. And distraction is a great thing. We're going to dive
For sure.
We're going to dive into distraction during grief. What's healthy and what's not.
Okay, good.
Katie, there's someone I want you to meet.
Gotcha.
Do you remember how much you liked Bruce? I think you're going to like Megan even.
Oh my gosh.
See, Bruce requires someone else to operate him.
Again, the production design in here is subtle but great. It's doing a lot.
Okay. What I want you to do is take your fingers and put them here.
It's the sterile clinical play space.
That means she will. Well, and then the red room where they observe everything.
Which is yours and yours alone.
She's gonna pair with Megan.
Keep your fingers there and say your name.
Hi, Megan. I'm Katie.
It's nice to meet you, Katie.
That is the correct response.
Correct response.
Ooh, I like that jacket. Where'd you get it?
But you talk a lot how the eyes are the window to the soul. When her pupils are small, Katie's scared. Once they open up, Katie's like, oh, okay.
It looks good on you. Do you want to hang out? Okay.
Scared, but kind of amused and liking it.
I do wonder how much, like, M3GAN fashion is going to just become fashion.
Yeah.
She's so stylishly dressed, but it's so specific.
Here's Katie. She's lost her parents. Her aunt isn't really attaching with helping, you know, helping her through. She's not really attached to her aunt because she tries.
There's nothing there.
Oh, I'm sorry. Do you like it, Katie?
Such an amazing...
I love it.
Like, do you like it, Katie? Just barely creepy.
Yeah.
But, like, the score is playing the joy and the wonder, and then she's just barely off.
She's, like, 95% warm and nurturing with just a little...
With 5% serial killer.
Yeah.
And it's so good. Oh, I love this movie.
And so now when she says M3GAN's going to pair with you, symbolically, you are going to bond with the technology instead of with your actual flesh and blood relative.
Right.
M3GAN is on a constant quest for self-improvement. Whether it's diagnosing children with specific learning differences or merely reminding them of the way science is all around us.
Katie, you should use a coaster.
Why do I have to use a coaster?
Coasters help to avoid watermarks, especially on wooden surfaces.
But how does the water get outside the glass?
That's a great question, Katie. It's actually caused by the difference in temperature outside the glass, which pulls moisture from the air.
Crazy.
It's insane, right?
She'll never run out of ways to keep your child occupied, and she'll never run out of patience.
Katie, seriously, flush the toilet.
She'll never run out of patience, except she did already.
With M3GAN around, she'll take care of the little things, so you can spend more time doing the things that matter.
Ouch.
The marketing copy is exactly what you would write in marketing copy. I know, I've directed dozens of commercials, some for tech products. It's very much like that. But intercutting that with what she's actually doing is just a gut punch to me as a parent, like, oh, shit, how many times have I done that?
Yeah. What really matters, what I'm working on, what really matters, this project, my career, this, that, or the other, and we'll let the television or the video games handle the kids, because sometimes we see our kids as obstacles instead of the purpose or the thing that really matters. And I've been guilty of that. And anytime I...
Look, every parent has. Like, it's... Let's be honest. Sometimes your kids are obstacles.
Yeah.
If you're a kid, sometimes you're the obstacle. It's okay. It doesn't mean your parents don't love you.
And we criticize parents who, they take their kids to the playground and then you see like the parents on the phone while the kids are playing. And I've heard both sides of that. One, put the phone away and engage with your kids. The other, I need a break.
Both are right.
They're
at
both,
different times.
Exactly. They're both right.
Yeah.
I would say gauge why you're on your phone. Are you on your phone because it's what you do? Or are you on your phone because... you're about to lose your shit on your kid, and they should be on the playground while you calm down and watch something that, or play a game that helps you to get, you know what I mean? But like, some of the best bonding I've done with my kids, I've been on my phone and I'm like, what am I doing? And I put it away.
You
and
put
I
it away
actually,
and then you go play.
Yeah. But what does happen is a form of psychological bonding, not in a relational sense, probably because we don't have actual M3GANs that we, you know, but in the sense of, okay, I'm going to distract myself from my boredom, from my sorrow, from my grief, from anything else, and I'm going to connect with the game, I'm going to connect with the movie, to the point where I don't really have a desire to connect with you, mom or dad, because you haven't made the effort and I just don't care anymore, this is more fun. And we start to see that here.
Your thumb's so slippery.
Katie, you should have some of your hot dog before it gets too cold.
Come on, Dad. Come on.
Katie, your hot dog.
Now she's all bratty.
Hey, I'm sorry about today. I shouldn't have put you in that position if you weren't feeling up to it.
It worked out, didn't it?
3, 2, 1, I win!
Hey!
Well, anyway, I just wanted to say that. Hey, Megan, turn off.
Why did you do that? Megan, turn on.
Because I'm trying to have a conversation with you, Katie. Megan, turn off. Just give me 1 minute. I know that this hasn't been easy for either of us, this transition. But if you ever need to talk about any of that stuff...
I already did talk about it.
Yeah, but Megan's not a person, Katie. She's a toy.
You don't get to say that.
What?
I said I don't want to talk about it. I want to turn Megan back on. Megan, turn on.
What's up?
So there's this new game called Tic-Tac-Toe. You put your hand like this, go like this, this.
Katie no longer wants Gemma's attention.
Right.
She prefers Megan for emotional connection, and she's kind of a brat about it.
Kind of?
Perpetual pets suck! They suck shit!
Hey! You know, as a parent, you're like, it's time to be done with screen time when your kids start acting a certain way.
One of the most fun conversations that we constantly have with our kids is screen time is not an absolute.
Mm-hmm.
And it changes all the time based on your behavior.
We have a half an hour to an hour a day once chores and schoolwork is done.
Sure.
And then Friday night is like...
Oh, movie night with Dad, right?
Movie night or video games or whatever.
Sure.
And as long as you're being cool about it, the limits are...
Yeah, kind of go hog wild.
Yeah, exactly, right? And so that's...
It's cheat day.
Yeah, it is. It's mental cheat day. Now, let's explore what happens when people get attached to technology over people.
Ooh, I was wondering if we were going to... This is the attachment theory.
Yeah, the movie version versus real life.
Let's see.
But Megan's actually been pretty instrumental in helping Katie get over the loss.
Katie's therapist.
It's honestly like she's part of the family now. Right.
Right here.
Well, and Gemma just saying, get over the loss. Attachment theory? Oh, she's over it.
When a child loses a parent, they look to form attachments with the next person that comes into their life. The person that's going to provide love and support and serve as a behavioral model, which in an ordinary situation would be you, right? But you've created a toy that's so real, it's possible that Katie might not see her as a toy, but as a primary caregiver. I guess I just don't quite see what the end goal is here. If you make a toy that's impossible to let go of, then how do you ever expect a child to grow? As remarkable as she is, and she is remarkable, you could be building emotional connections with this doll that are too hard to untangle.
Okay, so I'm going to speak both as a movie fan and as a therapist. Mm-hmm. That is half real psychology, half here's what we need a therapist
here's
to say.
What, here's
for
what
our
we
plot.
Need so that it can be scary later.
Right.
Yeah.
And so what she says, have you heard of attachment theory? And then she goes on to talk about when a child loses a parent or primary caregiver, they form attachments with somebody else. And that's only tangentially related to attachment theory.
That's not actually what attachment theory
is. Yeah, attachment theory is about secure attachments versus insecure attachments.
Right.
And she speaks about it as if attachment theory were about being orphaned. And it's not.
No.
And
so in this, would you say she has kind of an insecure attachment to Gemma and a more secure attachment to Megan?
Katie is forming a secure attachment in the sense that Megan is there for her.
Mm-hmm.
Megan is nurturing. Megan is welcoming. Megan is loving. And Megan is, again, I mean, I just said this, but always there. And so we form insecure attachments when we feel like someone might not be there for us, or they're there for us inconsistently.
Yeah.
Either literally or emotionally, right?
Sure.
Or that someone is abusive or neglectful. This leads to insecure attachment. Insecure attachment is what Katie is forming with Megan, except for Megan's a serial killer.
You killed people.
Oh, big whoop.
Would you form a secure attachment with someone who is preventing you from ever feeling any negative
things? Oh, that's a good question.
Things? Because that's what's happening here.
And that's leading to Katie's being kind of a spoiled brat.
Yes.
Is that Megan is not actually a parent. She is a genie.
She's an enabler of joy and happiness exclusively.
Yeah, well, more pleasure than joy and happiness. It's whatever Katie wants, Katie gets. And then when Katie doesn't get what she wants...
It's just a constant sugar high.
Exactly.
Yeah, exactly.
Especially because Gemma's saying...
Megan's actually been pretty instrumental in helping Katie get over the loss.
Mm. Get over the loss. And it's like, that's not how grief works.
She put a candy coating around it. That's all she did.
Yeah, exactly. The pain is still there, but what Megan is providing is a nonstop distraction. You said candy coating. Mm-hmm. And we do this as adults. We do this as kids. I don't want to feel the pain that I'm feeling, so I'm just going to escape and escape and escape. But what happens when we run from it nonstop? We become so afraid of facing it that that distraction dominates our life. And this is how people get into addictions of all kinds, right?
Yes, that's how my addiction started.
Okay, Katie, look, I know that you're upset, but there are ways that we can work through this. Oh, my God, okay. Katie, stop that right now. Stop it. Let go. Katie.
That is so much meatier of a slap than a little kid could land.
It's okay. Could you give us a minute? Effect.
I do love this scene, though, where it ends up is so great.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean it. It's just I get so crazy without M3GAN. She always knows just what to say. You made her real good on Gemma. Can you
see her? I love that they did a subtle makeup on Katie to make her look like a junkie.
I don't think that's a good idea.
But if something's broke, you don't just throw it away. You fix it, right? Why did you do this if you were just going to take her away from me?
Because I thought she would help.
She does help. When M3GAN's around, I don't feel like this.
But you should feel like this. Katie, you lost your parents. The worst thing that could have happened to you in this world happened. And it is so unfair, and there is nothing anyone can say.
I was so surprised to see this scene in this movie.
Mm-hmm.
I am so sorry. I should have talked to you about what happened. I didn't know what to say, so I did the only thing I knew how to do, but she's not a solution. She's just a distraction.
Yes,
like you were saying.
That these feelings you're feeling are ever gonna go away. But I can promise you that you'll get through it. We both will.
I just wish I could see them again.
Yeah. I do too. You know I made a promise to your mom that if anything happens, I would be there for you. You are all that matters to me now.
To your point about the marketing copy.
Mm-hmm.
What about M3GAN? What about the launch?
Because in the marketing copy says, M3GAN takes care of the kids so you can focus on what matters.
Focus on what matters. This is what matters.
Yeah. It's such a strongly written scene. And honestly, I have zero complaints or tweaks to it. It is perfect.
It is very, very good. Yeah.
And it is psychologically 100% accurate. We need to feel grief. Because it's part of our emotional experience. It's part of being emotionally healthy. We care, we lose, we grieve.
Yeah.
And if we deny ourselves that, what's going to happen is we stop caring.
Mm-hmm.
And we stop connecting. And we stop living. Like actually living a real life. And distractions, listen, distractions are fantastic. I mean, there's nothing better when you are ramping up psychologically with things to distract yourself with something that helps bring that down and then to say, okay.
So that you can then deal with it.
Yeah.
But that's the important part is then deal with it.
Yes. And this is one of my favorite reasons to, people ask me, you deal with heavy stuff in your office.
Sure.
How do you cope with that? And I'm like, you already know because we've got the YouTube channel. I go to movies.
This.
Yeah. I go to movies and I just like immerse myself in that. And then I come out and I'm like, okay. Let's deal with life again. And when it comes to grief, I love she says,
I can't promise you that these feelings you're feeling are ever going to go away. But I can promise you that you'll get through it.
And that is so powerful.
It really is. And I have no notes on how they got here.
Yeah.
Like, it is a completely believable character journey for Gemma. It is a completely believable character journey for Katie to arrive at this scene. After this scene, stuff goes banana cuckoo pants, and I love it.
Yeah.
It's fun murder times.
You know something, Gemma? You're exhausting.
And there's a TikTok dance and all kinds of great stuff. But this is the sort of emotional climax of the film.
Yeah.
Afterwards is just like, hey, let's survive murder now.
Well, but we also get a little bit more of, you know, when I was talking about earlier, turning off your phone at night and putting it away, just how hard it is to break free from M3GAN and they do it
for
together,
sure.
You know? And so they make it like awesome action horror, figurative.
But it's still, it's addressing, you know, in an intelligent way, an actual thing.
Yeah. This movie had no right. I was expecting, no, seriously, I saw the trailer, I'm like, this is going to be some...
This looks like fun, dumb fun.
Yeah, this is Robo Chucky, which we actually got Robot Chucky, but this is Girl Robot Chucky, and I'm like, okay.
Sure, that'll be a fun time at the movies, and holy crap, it's actually really good.
Yeah, really smart, really dramatically sound, well acted, really funny, and clinically, spot on. I love this, bring on the sequel.
Turns out this James Wan guy, I think he's got a future.
Oh my gosh.
I'm going to tell him.
Don't you dare.
So until next time.
It's insane, right?
This is the part where you run.
And
watch movies.
Oh, Alan, turn off. We want to thank our patrons for helping us produce this episode. Go to patreon.com/cinematherapy. You support us and you get a lot of bonus content that you can't get anywhere else.
It's good.
Our thanks to our patrons including
Patsy Real,
Zem Haisong,
Emily Gardner,
Angelica Switzer,
B.A. Barry. He's got a Bachelor of Arts in Barry.
Or Ba Barry.
Ba Barry.